Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop 2019 double exposure tutorial, we'll be doing this wolf and forest photo merge. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. Don't forget to subscribe as well, and you can also help support this channel through Patreon. There's a link for that in the description. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop, and there's a link for that in the description as well. Okay, let's get to it. We'll start this project off with a brand new file. Let's just close this one down. There we go. And then I'll do create new right here, or of course you could go up to the file menu and new there. Either way is fine. So create new. We'll do this new file in the default Photoshop size, which is 5x7 right there. And landscape orientation resolution of 300. And then choose create. There we go. We can just go ahead and fit screen on this. Now we're only using two pictures on this, the wolf and the forest background picture. We'll start off with the wolf, so place embedded here so that the image is embedded into the file and not linked to an outside file. And there we go. Now I have this image and this forest image. Links for both of these are on my website. You can find a link for that in the description so you can download these and work with them as well. Now notice that the image is just a bit too small here, so let's just zoom out just a little bit on the image. I'm using the scrubby zoom right there. And we use the Control T keyboard shortcut to give us our control handles. And then let's go ahead and resize the wolf picture to mostly fill the frame. Not all the way, but most of it. Kind of like that's pretty good. I'm leaving a bit more space on the left side then on the right hand side, so we're about right there. Looks good. I think that will work out fine for our picture. Right there, that looks nice. Okay. But right now we need to remove the existing background. Let's first get this back up here to fit screen again. There we go. And to remove the background, we'll use the select and mask right there. And there it is. Now the easy way to use this is to start off with your top option up here. This is the quick selection tool. I'll put smart radius on. I'll leave everything else at their default settings. And then just begin coming in here and let Photoshop find where the wolf is. Now this won't do a perfect job on the fur on the edges. We'll come back and we'll clean that up in just a bit. Let's first take care of all of this stuff. Just go through with the select and mask and let it fill in all those areas. That gets most of it taken care of right there. Now let's go back, change our tool over here. This is the Refine Edge Brush tool. And with this tool, come along and just go right over the edge. This will then have Photoshop re-examine that edge and clean up that fur for us. And just go clear around the whole edge. Luckily, this is working on a white background anyway, so if there's any little problems, it's really not going to show. So this would be a real nice solution for that. Don't worry about that bit of snow down there. We'll be taking care of that in a different way. Okay, just working clear around the edge here of this wolf. And now the back side, which of course has the longer fur. Now with the longer fur, you may have to come in and do a couple of passes to catch all that fur. Just do a pass on the inside first and then come a little bit further out for your second and third pass, and that should catch that fur just fine. There we go. Okay, let's get the fur along the back side here and it'll finish up around the head, and we should then have a nice clean selection to work with. Now the select a mask is kind of odd. Sometimes it works out great, sometimes it works just horribly. It really depends upon your picture. In this particular instance, this picture works out very well with the select and mask because they have a real nice contrast difference between the foreground and the background. Nice dark wolf in the foreground, nice white background. Fairly easy image to use this tool on. Okay, that looks good. Once you have your runaround here with the Refine Edge tool, and the edges all look good. Then come down here to the Output section, and you want to output to New Layer with New Layer Mask right there. Choose OK. And there's our layer with the layer mask. Nice clean selection. That worked out just fine. Okay, now we want to have that snow down below, but nothing else in the background. So let's go ahead and reshow our background. And let's put a layer mask on this layer. So come down to the layer mask button. There it is. There's our layer mask. Let's zoom out just a little bit. I'll use the scrubby zoom again. That's click and drag left to zoom out, drag right to zoom in. There you are. And grab the paintbrush. I have it set at a real large size here. It's at 500 pixels, real soft, hardness of 0. And it's black paint. And then just paint right on that layer mask, right across the top like this. And then just go back and forth until you're almost down to the feet, right down in there. So I'm leaving the bottom section where the feet are, and that little bit of snow right down there, leaving that alone. And we're painting in almost the whole background area here. And if you come in too far down below, which I think we did, let's just switch to the white for foreground color and then come in across the bottom just like that. And make sure that we're still showing all the snow at the bottom of the picture. Okay, that takes care of that. So we have two layers now. One layer, we're just seeing that bit right down here. And the second layer is the wolf in front. So it's just that and the wolf. You can actually come down just a little bit further than this. Let's bring our black in again, back to our paintbrush. And I'll come down just a little bit further right there. Let's bring the brush size down. That's too far. Maybe about halfway, about 250 or so. 229, close enough. Come down just a little bit more right down here without getting into the snow, but just like that. Okay, that takes care of that bottom bit. So that's the feet and the snow down here. Let's now come in and put our forest picture in. So go to the top layer up here. Go back to File and Place Embedded. And there's the forest picture. It says Transylvania. That's good. And there's the forest. And it's about the right size already in here. It's a little bit off, as you can see, but it's just about the right size in there. You can get it real close by bringing the opacity down about halfway, and then we can actually see the picture in here. Now, what you want to have is the forest road right here coming out just above that leg. So there's the forest road just above the leg. That's fine. And then we have our trees in here. And these two trees are sticking up just a little bit up beyond the back right there. So that's about the right position for this. Right around in there is pretty good. So right there. Looks good. Okay. Let's go ahead and bring this back up to full visibility. And we'll set that in place. There we are. We now need to put this inside of the wolf. Real easy to do. Just come down to the wolf layer here. Hold the Alt key, click on the layer mask, hold the Alt key, and pull that straight up. That copies that layer mask up, so that's just about where we want it. Now, we want to hide a lot of this stuff in here that we're not going to be using. I want to hide some of the wolf in the back right there and show more trees. And I want to hide this bottom of the picture down here and show more wolf and show the wolf's face. All of that is done by working on the layer mask. So let's go to our layer mask over here. And let's go back to our paintbrush. We have that set at, let's set clear up to 250. Maybe 300, a little bit larger. That's pretty good. 300 is good size. Make sure you're at a hardness of 0. That's fine. And then to hide the layer mask up here, to hide anything, come down here with the black and then just paint in black like that. We'll come in and paint it just a little bit right down here. And just hiding a little bit of that forest along that point. And then work along up here. You want to show the whole wolf head. There we go. The wolf head looks good. And then we want to hide the back of the wolf right here, and that's on the wolf layer. So come down to the wolf layer here, and we're still on black. I'm just going to hide a little bit of that wolf layer. Just a bit right in there. And then back up here to the tree layer, I want to show more of the trees now, so let's reverse these to white, and we'll bring back in the trees and take them clear up to the top. Just like that. And then we'll go back to the black. There we are. And I want to make sure we have that wolf head showing. There it is. And I want to get rid of a bit of this top stuff up in here, but I want a larger brush for that. So let's go back up to that 500. There we go. And then let's come in and just kind of paint in along the top up here and get rid of some of that sky that's showing, leaving some of this other stuff, but getting rid of some of that sky. And that brings back in those trees nicely in there. And I'll come in just a little bit at the bottom right down here where the wolf is. And a little more on that side. So we get the trees only showing just in kind of the middle section in here like that. Okay, so far so good. We have the ground, we have our basic wolf, our basic merge in there. Let's now do one more thing. Take this tree layer here, right click and duplicate that layer. Take the duplicate and pull it underneath the wolf layer. We're above the feet layer, under the wolf layer. And here I want to show more of that. So we're going back to our white coloration. So our paintbrush, make sure we're on the layer mask side. There we are. And then right in here, now make sure I'm white. There you go. Just pull that straight across. And that brings back in a lot of that background. Now go back to black again, and we're on the layer mask. And then let's just come in and fade that out along around that edge. Just kind of paint that out like that. Let's get a nice softness around the edge of that part of the picture, kind of in behind the wolf there. There we go. Real nice bit of coloration showing in the background, but not too much. Now, last little touches on this one. We can move this layer down just a bit. Let's go back up here to the Move tool. And I'll use my down arrow, down cursor, and just bring this down just a little bit here. I want to see a little bit more of that picture down there. That's pretty good right there. Now, I'm seeing a little bit of the top up here. I don't want to see that. I'm going to pull this over to the left just a little bit as well. It's a little bit better composition. Kind of like that. Okay, back to the black. We're still on the layer mask, paintbrush, and let's paint out that top bit up there so you don't have anything showing that shouldn't show. And there we go. There is our nice photo merge. Now, a couple little last things. I want to bring down the saturation a little bit on the trees and on this background, on those two layers. We'll do that with adjustment layers. Let's go up to layer. Come down to new adjustment layer, and let's go to hue saturation, where it says use previous layer to create clipping mask. Check that, choose OK. Now I'm on the tree line here behind the wolf, and there's our controls under the properties here. Just bring the saturation to the left back of it. See, there's full saturation. Just bring it back just a bit. Take it down to about negative 50, about halfway. There we go. So it's not quite black and white, but it's not really full saturation either. Do the exact same thing for the foreground trees. Let's go up here, that's our top layer. And layer, come down to new adjustment layer. And again, hue saturation. And again, check that checkbox right there. And pull the saturation down here. Also down to about negative 50. If you want, you can just type that in. There we go. And it's bringing down the saturation so it's not too bright and too colorful, which detracts from the wolf's head. And then one last little tweak in here. Come back to the top, one of the forest layers here, and bring the opacity down to about 80%. I'll just type in 80 on that. That just helps to soften up that blend right along those edges. And there we go. There is our double exposure.